Hello. In this episode of Redis Explained, I'm going to lay to rest several misconceptions many people have had about Redis, Redis Stack, and NoSQL. When I started out as a developer, I knew very little about Redis and what it was capable of. Now I hope to give you a bit of insight into all that Redis has to offer. Myth number one, Redis is just a cache. This one is very common. Redis is great at being a cache. It's fast, it's reliable, and almost everyone uses it as a cache layer for their main data store. Redis is great at taking queries from hundreds of milliseconds down to less than a millisecond. But the truth is, you can use Redis and its many data structures for a lot more than just caching. For example, you can do message queuing, event sourcing, distributed session storage, and geospatial indexing. And with the querying and indexing that you get from Redis Stack, you can model complex application domains using Redis as a source of record or as a highly efficient front-end database. Redis has become an essential component of most application stacks. And as it turns out, it can do a lot of heavy lifting for you. Myth number two, Redis is only in memory. So if there's a server crash or failure, you lose everything. This is definitely not true. Redis stores all its data in memory first, yes, but Redis also has multiple options baked in for persisting your data set to durable storage. The Redis persistence systems use a combination of point-in-time snapshots and append-only logs, with snapshots enabled by default. Also, most folks run Redis in a replicated, high-availability configuration. This means that even in the event of a node failure, your Redis database and data will still be available. All of that to say, even though your data is always served from memory, Redis persistence and replication ensures that you won't lose data on restarts and failures. Myth number three, because your Redis database size is limited to the total amount of memory across a cluster, you can't use Redis for any real applications. This is my favorite, as I thought the same thing when I first started using Redis. Many Redis use cases deal with ephemeral data. These include caching, messaging, streaming, and queuing. When dealing specifically with session storage or caching use cases, Redis has built-in expiration functionality that will automatically remove a key after a given amount of time. Individual keys may be assigned a TTL, or time to live, which can be updated by a client to suit the use case. And if the case ever arises that you do get close to exceeding your memory allocation, Redis has numerous options on how to handle the situation. Do you refuse any new keys and return an error? Do you evict keys that are least recently used? These are just two of many eviction policies that you can configure your Redis Stack instance to follow. If you're running low on memory, Redis can also scale horizontally. With Redis Cloud, you can do this seamlessly with the press of a button. Also, within Redis Enterprise, Redis on Flash is an option. This is where hot data, or data that is frequently accessed, stays in RAM and less frequently accessed or inactive data is stored in flash memory. Redis Enterprise manages the RAM to flash balance for you. This significantly increases your storage space while reducing operating costs. There are a lot of options to explore to ensure that you never reach your memory limit. And finally, myth number four. Managing your own open source Redis deployment is cost effective. Yes, Redis is open source and highly reliable, and you're free to deploy it and manage it yourself. But operating a database is no small feat. You need to think about scaling, backups, monitoring and alerting, upgrades and uptime. And for all of this, well, you're going to need a dedicated operations team. It's usually a lot easier, less time consuming, and more cost effective to use Redis Cloud, the database as a service hosted on your favorite cloud provider. Let someone else worry about the five nines and clustering. Or, if you're deploying on-premises, consider Redis Enterprise software, which comes with support and is designed to alleviate the pains of self-management. All right, those were the four most common myths I've encountered while working with Redis. If you've heard any other myths or have any questions, don't hesitate to leave a comment below or join us in our Redis Discord channel to start the conversation. If you'd like to learn more about Redis, head over to Redis University, where you can learn the ins and outs of building on Redis. If you'd like to try out Redis Cloud for free, click on the link in the description below. You'll have an instance of Redis Stack to try at your convenience. You'll also find information on Redis Enterprise if you're looking for a fully managed Redis solution. As always, Thank you for stopping by, and I'll see you later.